Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Boris Johnson did not go far enough with his article, which said burka wearing women look like letterboxes, according to his father. The former foreign secretary has caused outrage by giving his opinion on the burqa ban row. While Mr. Johnson wrote in the Daily Telegraph the clothes worn by women of Islamic faith should not be banned, he received international condemnation for saying the women look like bank robbers. His father Stanley Johnson, a writer, environment expert and former MP, has become the latest high-profile figure to back him up. However, Mr. Johnson Sr. said he should have gone further. Writing in the Sunday Telegraph, Stanley Johnson said, "Yes, Boris used some colorful language. That's called freedom of speech, or it was in my day." Boris Johnson's father has backed his comments over the burqa, but said his son should have called for a ban in some circumstances. Pictured, Boris Johnson and his dad Stanley Johnson ban the burqa. Women have been outraged by Boris Johnson's comments calling them letterboxes, insisting the right to wear the covering clothing should be protected. But he said what needed to be said. As a matter of fact, I would have liked him to have gone a bit further. He was against banning the burqa. But surely, there are circumstances where a ban or appropriate restrictions would be in order. Shouldn't female school teachers, nurses or doctors be seen as well as heard? At least the House of Commons could have a sensible debate on this issue. Mr. Johnson Sr. said support for his son's views was near universal among people he spoke to in Somerset. And he added, "Why the all furore? Why has this disastrous blue-on-blue warfare broken out? The chairman of the Conservative Party is setting up a committee of inquiry into whether Boris's use of the word letterbox breaches party rules. Burqa-wearing women said they do not have their rights stripped and do not wear the garments for men. They insist they should never be banned in Britain." Stanley Johnson has been stopped at events in the last week with people congratulating his son on his burqa article. However, Muslims in Britain are furious. If that isn't a known goal, I don't know what is. Mr. Corbyn must be rubbing his hands with glee. A pro-Boris backlash is growing after the Tory party yesterday announced that it has opened an investigation into Mr. Johnson after he compared women wearing burqas with letterboxes and bank robbers. What did Boris Johnson say about the burqa and the niqab? The ex-foreign secretary sparked a storm of controversy after using his weekly newspaper column to compare women who wear burqas to letterboxes and bank robbers. The burqa is a full face covering that is associated with a conservative interpretation of Islam. It is different to the hijab, which leaves the face uncovered, or the niqab, which leaves the eyes exposed. In his Daily Telegraph article, Mr. Johnson said that he felt fully entitled to expect women who wear face coverings to take them off when talking to him at his MP surgery. He also said schools and universities are entitled to take the same approach if a pupil comes in looking like a bank robber. Mr. Johnson branded the burqa oppressive and said it is weird and bullying to expect people to cover their faces. He added that he could not find scriptural authority for the dress code in the Quran. And he said, "It is absolutely ridiculous that people should choose to go around looking like letterboxes." Allies of the ex-cabinet minister tore into the probe and accuse number 10 of being behind a witch hunt to destroy Mr. Johnson because they see him as a threat. Mr. Johnson, who is currently on holiday in a rented villa in Italy, has not commented on the furore his remarks sparked. Boris' father revealed he is not the only one to support Boris, as he has been stopped multiple times at home in Exmoor by people wishing to back his son. Rachel Johnson has also backed her sibling. She wrote, "If I'd been phoning it in, as it were, I might have changed the word ridiculous and cut out bank robbers, but apart from these two or three words, it seemed fine and fair. In fact, it didn't go far enough to express, in my view, how oppressive the garment is. When I see a woman wearing one, I don't try to other her. The reverse. I try to imagine myself in her shoes. On the street, all the rest of my family are in casual shorts and t-shirts and flip-flops, but I'm a faceless, unidentifiable ghost in a suffocating black shroud. On the beach, my man in skimpy speedos, okay, please know, me in hot dark fabric from head to toe, having to eat an ice cream by posting the pudding into my mouth from under a flap beneath my chin." Ms. Johnson also called for her brother to go further, saying she would only apologize for his having not called for an outright ban. The Tory party announced last week it had received a flurry of complaints about Mr. Johnson, automatically triggering an investigation into him. Rachel Johnson and Boris Johnson. Rachel has also backed her brother over his burqa comments despite the huge backlash the ex-foreign secretary faces, being punished by party bosses and could even be kicked out of the party over the remarks, although this is very unlikely. Under Tory party rules, an investigating officer will now decide if Mr. Johnson has flouted their code of conduct and if the probe should be referred on to a panel to grill him on. Theresa May will decide what punishment to mete out to her former minister.